सारे दर्शकों ने मेरे वालों प्यार भरी सत श्री अकाल तुहाडा स्वागत प्रोग्राम अज दा मुद्दा दे विच मैं तुहाडी होस्ट आशमिता सारिआं नूं इस प्रोग्राम दे विच एक बारी फिर स्वागत करदे आं। मैं कहांगी पिछले साल तों जदों तों इंडिया दे विच किसानी मुद्दा उठिआ उस टाइम तो लगातार इस मंच से उसकी कवरेज हो रही है, भावें वह मोर्चे नूं लैके हुए दिल्ली दे विच किस तरह सरहदा ते किसान मोर्चा लग्या होया है या पंजाब दे विच की कुछ राजनीति चल रही है किसानां नूं लैके की हकीकत हैगी साइंटिफिक तौर पर एग्रीकल्चर इकोनमी ते मॉडल नूं लैके इन सारी चीज़ों पर कवरेज तुहाडे नाल पेश कर रहे हैं। बट जिथे किसानी ते एग्रीकल्चर मॉडल की गल आती है अक्सर इस मंच से तुहाडे नाल वख वख साइंटिस्ट ते एग्रीकल्चर एक्सपर्ट्स नूं भी जोड़ते हैं सो अंडरस्टैंड द साइंस के की फैक्ट्स सानू दसदे है कि सिर्फ राजनीतिक तौर पर या एक कॉमन मैन एक कॉमन किसान का परसपैक्टिव नहीं बट एक साइंटिस्ट का परसपैक्टिव इतने समझना बहुत जरूरी है साढ़े सारे लिए। सो मैनू अज बहुत खुशी हो रही है कि इस ही पक्ष से अज का मुद्दा तुहाडे नाल मैं पेश कर रही हाँ। एक बहुत ही मैं कहांगी एस्टीम्ड ऑनरेबल गैसट साढ़े नाल अज जुड़े हैं, मैनू बहुत सन्मानित फील हो रहा है मान सम्मान फील हो रहा है कि एक गैसट साढ़े नाल इस प्रोग्राम दे विच जुड़े बिकॉज ना कि सिर्फ एग्रीकल्चर की गल होएगी बट जिथे प्रॉब्लम की गल हुंदी है उते हल की भी गल होनी जरूरी हैगी ते अज कुछ इहो जिहे सोल्यूशनस की गल करांगे जो इंडिया की एग्रीकल्चर इकोनमी लई एक वायबल तौर पर ऑफर हो सकते हैं एंड मैं कहांगी ये सोल्यूशनस कितने ना कितने हद तक प्रैक्टिस भी हो रहे हैं। सो इन सारी चीज़ों पर गल करन लई साडे गैसट अज सानू ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं। प्लीज़ ज्वाइन मी इन वेलकमिंग इन द प्रोग्राम टुनाइट ज्वाइनिंग अस फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र डॉक्टर सुभाष पालेकर जी। सब तो पहले डॉक्टर पालेकर जी तुहाडा प्रोग्राम दे विच स्वागत सत श्री अकाल नमस्कार वेलकम टू द शो सर।
सत श्री अकाल और सभी हमारे जो पंजाबी महानुभाव हुए आदरण नमस्कारम।
So good to have you. So good to have you, Dr. Palekar ji. And you know, I do want to for the viewers that don't know, aap bahut ek well esteemed and well regarded agriculture scientist, farmer, author. Your works have been widely published and implemented. But I want to let everyone know that not only are you the recipient of a Padma Shri Award in 2016, but jo aapki specifically ek थियोरी हैगी द सुभाष पालेकर नेचुरल फार्मिंग थियोरी एज वेल एज द जीरो बजट नेचुरल फार्मिंग थियोरी दीज थिंग्स आर नॉट ओनली प्रैक्टिस इन सर्टेन पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया दे आर प्रैक्टिस सक्सेसफुली एंड इन चीज़ों पर आपने प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी तक मोदी जी को आपने प्रेजेंटेशन दी है। सो आई वॉन्ट टॉक अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स। सबसे पहले डॉक्टर पालेकर Once again, welcome to the program. Dr. Palekar, you've done so many things, but aaj ki date mein, what is the thing that you are most actively involved with today?
Basically, I am giving the solutions to all problems, not only related to agriculture. I am giving the solution related to environmental losses and suicide of the farmers, degradation of the soil, and climate change, and migration of the youth from the rural area to urban area, socio-economic, social, and also agriculture problems. And there was no any solution has been given up to now by agriculture universities and so-called experts. So I have tried since my research work, 1988 to 2000, 12 years I have taken the research work. I was continuously finding the solution because solution is most important. Analysis, we are listening so many analyzers, analysis. These are the root causes, these are the reasons, these are the reasons. What is the solution? Nobody is telling the solution.
Why do you Dr. Palekar, why do you think the solution is so actively avoided? Because you're right, you know, everyone likes to highlight the problems these days when it comes to not just India's agriculture, but the socioeconomics. But in your opinion, why do you feel that even the experts are failing to discuss the solutions?
Basically, what has happened? Now I will give some example. पंजाब हरियाणा वेस्टर्न यूपी बिहार इज द पॉकेट ऑफ द green revolution, which has given surplus production of the wheat and rice, too much more than requirement. Mm-hmm. The central agriculture minister said that 37% wheat is lost actually by the rats and all these.
It's rotting silos in the silos.
There's no problem. Yeah, yeah. Number one. Number two, wheat is not a food of Indian people. Yeah. Basically.
Yeah.
Before Green Revolution, nobody Indian was eating fruit, wheat. Everybody was eating swargam, main jowar, pearl millet, bajra, finger millet, proso millet, and brown top millet, barland millet, all millets.
Millets.
Nobody was eating wheat because wheat is not an Indian food, so our intestine is not habitual to digest wheat. Wheat has a gluten, which is very complicated for digestion system, and wheat is a acidic. White rice is acidic, and in wheat only 1.2% fiber. If we want to free from constipation and free of the diseases, we want minimum 3.6% fiber in our food.
Fiber, G.
Fiber. Wheat is having only 1.2%. White rice only 0.2%. That means wheat creates so many problems. Now wheat is the main food. What are the health problems we are facing in India, and I think they are in Southeast Asia and African countries also, because they are not having the wheat is the food. They were eating millets since thousands of years. So these problems are the health problem, number one. Number two, wheat and rice want maximum water, irrigation water. Without irrigation water, we can't grow wheat and rice. And when you export 1 kg basmati rice to America, Europe countries, you are losing 2,500 liter water. That means we are exporting the water. On other side, in India, today also, 82% land under dry land, rain fed, no irrigation facility, maximum. And they are facing stress, water stress. They are not getting surplus rainfall also due to climate change. So to utilize 100 times of the water, irrigation water in rice and wheat, which is not the food actually, it is, I think that it is a wrong decision. We have to come to conclusion that we have to change our food habits and we have to use maximum millets. And millets, you know, madam, millets complete their life cycle within 3 months, 90 days. Very doubtful. That means in drought also they can survive and give best production in low rainfall also. So it is not necessary to give the irrigation. What are the problems that happened in Punjab, Haryana? A loss of fertility of the soil, loss of the environmental establishment, and loss of health problem are due to this unnatural food.
Dr. Palekar, I'm so glad that you gave us the consumer perspective, right? Because when it comes to the agriculture crisis that's afflicting India right now, oftentimes the conversation stops at the farmers' issues. But when it comes to the food topic, the issue is two-faced. It is the producers as well as the consumers. I want to ask you a little bit about your Subhash Palekar natural farming theory and how it's being implemented. We have to stop for a quick commercial break here. Dr. Subhash Palekar, please stay with us. Viewers, Susubi Sarnal is tarah jude raho, conversation jai rahegi. Break to spar. ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰੀ ਫਿਰ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਵੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਅੱਜ ਦਾ ਮੁੱਦਾ ਗੱਲ ਹੋ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਵਿਦ ਇਨ ਐਗਰੀਕਲਚਰ ਸਾਇੰਟਿਸਟ ਅ ਫਾਰਮਰ ਇਨ ਆਥਰ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਕ੍ਰੀਏਟਰ ਆਫ ਦ ਸੁਭਾਸ਼ ਪਾਲੇਕਰ ਨੈਸ਼ਨਲ ਫਾਰਮਿੰਗ ਥਿਊਰੀ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰੀ ਫਿਰ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਸੁਭਾਸ਼ ਪਾਲੇਕਰ ਜੀ ਆਈ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਯੂ ਬੈਕ ਟੂ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਹਾਂਜੀ
ਯੂ ਸਪੀਕ ਇਨ ਇੰਡੀਅਨ ਇੰਗਲਿਸ਼ ਨਾਟ ਇਨ ਅਮਰੀਕਨ ਇੰਗਲਿਸ਼
Sure, sir. Dr. Palekar ji, you know, once again, we welcome you back to the program. It's so good to have you, sir. I want to share with our viewers that not only are you the recipient of the Padma Shri in 2016, but you were the first farmer who was a recipient of the award, and you're still working in this field. Dr. Palekar, I want you to walk us through your program that is being implemented in certain parts of the country, known as the Subhash Palekar Natural Farming Model. What does this theory entail?
I have given the name Subhash Palekar Natural Farming. Previous name was Zero Budget Natural Farming, but Zero Budget is not possible, so I have changed the name. Basically, in the nature, you go in the dense forest. You will see the huge tree of mango, tamarind with uncountable fruits every year without any human existence and assistance. And you cut down any leaf of any plant in the forest and investigate in the laboratory. You will see no deficiency of any nutrient in the plant body. No deficiency of nitrogen, phosphate, potassium, no deficiency of any micronutrient. That means all nutrients are available to the plant body. Who has given? In the forest, human is not existent. Who has given? That means nature has given. Nature has its own technology. Self-developing, self-nourishing, and self-reliant technology by which all nutrients are getting available naturally to the plant body. So it is not necessary to give any fertilizer, manure to the plant. I have taken the research in the forest for 12 years, and then I thought that there is a solid technology of the nature of the God, and that technology I have taken from nature. I have given the name Subhash Palekar Natural Farming.
What is this technology, sir, if you can walk us? I mean, for the layman who, you know, especially folks who maybe had a farming history in their past, but today they empathize with farmers, but they don't understand the science of it. What is this technology?
Since 10,000 years, every technologist in agriculture sector is claiming that no nutrients are existed in the soil. So we have to give externally by means of the manure and fertilizer. They are telling lies. They are misleading the entire world. I have proved, Subhash Palekar is the first farmer who proved that no manure and fertilizer is a food of any plant, not necessary to give, because in the forest, we are not utilizing any manure, any fertilizer, no deficiency. That means it is the scientific truth. 97 to 98.5% body of any plant, any tree, is constituted by only carbon dioxide taken from the atmosphere by photosynthesis, solar energy taken from the through the solar light, and water taken from the by the roots through the soil, but given by monsoon. That means three elements are major elements which occupy 98.5% body of the plant. Where there is a question is right there, manure and fertilizer is the food. And rest of the micronutrients are tremendous in the soil. Soil is ocean of the nutrient, because when there is no deficiency in the fruit, in the forestry, that means all nutrients are available, taken to the soil. If soil is deficited, there should be deficiency in the plant body, but there is no deficiency. That means all the nutrients are existing in the soil. Soil is ocean of the nutrient only. What are the nutrients are existing in the soil? They are not in available form. They are not in cooked form. They are in raw form. That means they are in raw form, not cooked. Roots want cooked form. Just I will see. Can you eat wheat? No. You can't eat rice.
You can't digest it. The body can't digest it.
We want bread. So microorganisms are the main role, having the main role to convert non-available into available form to supply the roots. That means there is a great responsibility has been given by the God to microorganisms in the soil who will cook the food and supply to the groceries. No manure is required, no fertilizer is required. Only we want the best culture of the microorganisms. And during my previous research work, I found the local cow dung is the best culture of the microorganisms. In 1 gram of the saiwal, you will say, in 1 gram of the saiwal cow, local cow in India, you will see more than 3,000 million of the beneficial microorganisms.
Ji.
It's the best culture. So I have utilized that local cow dung with urine, and I have prepared jivamrutam, ghana jivamrutam, as a culture, not as a manure, not as a fertilizer, because manure fertilizer is not a food of any roots of any plant body.
Ji.
And I have achieved that target, that without any chemical fertilizer and manure, we are getting tremendous results in throughout the world, not only in India.
Gee. So once again, Dr. Palekar, I just want to reiterate, you know, from my own understanding, so you're saying that currently, you know, the common practice is you use this kind of, you know, scientifically created manure or fertilizer, that's not needed, that you can provide a greater degree of nutrients and value to your crops by using, like your model suggests, maybe local cow dung or local cow urine. Is that correct?
5 million farmers are practicing Subhash Palekar natural farming in India. Since 20 years, they are not utilizing single gram of fertilizer manure. Not
wow.
at all.
Wow.
I am giving the challenge to the scientists. They have to come visit and then instigate. No deficiency they will get. No deficiency of any nutrient. It is very wrong, unscientific theory that manure and fertilizer are required. Totally untruth.
Wow.
Wrong.
This is a very interesting theory that you put forth. And I think the most important part here is how widely used it is, right? So I kind of want to move the discussion to that, how it's being implemented, you know, theory versus the actual practice. So we're going to stop for another quick break here. Dr. Subhash Palekar, please stay with us. Sorry. डॉक्टर पालेकर, प्लीज आप ऐसे ही हमारे साथ जुड़े रहिए. एक छोटी सी ब्रेक के लिए यहाँ पे रुकते हैं. व्यूअर्स, तुसी भी साथ नाल इस तरह जुड़े रहो. मिलते हैं ब्रेक तो उस पार. ब्रेक तो बार एक बार फिर मुड़ हाजिर हो. यहाँ गल हो रही है नेचुरल फार्मिंग दी एंड अल्टरनेटिव मेथड्स. अक्सर जदों फूड दी गल आती है, क्रॉप्स दी, एग्रीकल्चर दी गल आती है, यू नो, फर्टिलाइजर, मनूअर, जो ये एडिटिव्स तुहाडे खाने दे विच पाए जाते हैं शुरुआत तो, उन्हां दी गल चक्की जाती है. बट ਇਹਦਾ ਕੀ ਆਲਟਰਨੇਟਿਵ ਹੈਗਾ, ਇਹਦਾ ਕੀ ਹੱਲ ਹੋ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਹੋ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ. ਅਤੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਇਸ ਚੀਜ਼ 'ਤੇ ਡਿਸਕਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਨ ਲਈ ਐਕਸਪਰਟ ਇਨ ਦ ਫੀਲਡ, ਐਗਰੀਕਲਚਰ ਸਾਇੰਟਿਸਟ, ਫਾਰਮਰ, ਪਬਲਿਸ਼ਡ ਆਥਰ, ਰਿਸਿਪੀਐਂਟ ਆਫ ਦ ਪਦਮਾ ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਅਵਾਰਡ, ਦੀ ਫਸਟ ਫਾਰਮਰ ਟੂ ਰਿਸੀਵ ਦੀ ਅਵਾਰਡ, ਡਾਕਟਰ ਸੁਭਾਸ਼ ਪਾਲੇਕਰ ਜੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਜੁੜੇ ਹਨ. ਡਾਕਟਰ ਪਾਲੇਕਰ, ਵੈਲਕਮ ਬੈਕ ਵੰਸ ਮੋਰ. डॉक्टर पालेकर, आप हमें बता रहे थे कि ओवर 5 मिलियन पीपल इंडिया में आपके इस थियरी को, जो थियरी ही नहीं, उसको प्रैक्टिस में अपना रहे हैं सक्सेसफुल तरीके से. डॉक्टर पालेकर, मैं चाहूँगी कि आप हमें बताइए किस किस रीजन्स में, किस स्टेट्स में ये थियरी आज की डेट में सबसे ज़्यादा देखने को मिल रही है.
आंध्र प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट, हिमाचल प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट, गुजरात गवर्नमेंट एक्सेप्टेड सुभाष पालेकर नेचुरल फार्मिंग एज ए पॉलिसी एंड मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल आर प्रैक्टिसिंग इन दिस स्टेट. इवन विथ आवर मास मूवमेंट कंटिन्यूसली कंटिन्यूड सिंस 25 ईयर, वी हैव ए ग्रेट नेटवर्क इन इंडिया ऑफ द फार्मर्स एंड कंज्यूमर्स. सो आई थिंक दैट, but government of India has not declared clearly, but they are thinking about the policy. But I think that it is only technology, Subhash Palekar natural farming, which can solve all the problems not only related to agriculture, but environmental problem also. Global warming and climate change is the main issue. It's a global issue.
Tell us about that, Dr. Palekar, you know, because once again, we understand that these concepts are related, but maybe we don't understand exactly how. How does this theory, your Subhash Palekar natural farming theory, go from, you know, removing the use of manure, fertilizer, you know, providing a cleaner, more nutritious food source to people, then translate to sustainable for the environment?
I will give 2 points. Global warming and climate change. There are so many greenhouses are responsible. Mainly, carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, and methane are the prior greenhouse gases which are responsible for global and climate change. Maximum greenhouse gases are emitted by chemical farming and organic farming and industry sector. But in Subhash Palekar natural farming, no single gram of the greenhouse gas is emitted because the cow dung manure, compost, vermicompost, edible oil cakes, non-edible oil cakes, and chemical fertilizers are responsible to maximum emission of the greenhouse gases. In Subhash Palekar natural farming, we are not utilizing cow dung manure, no compost, no vermicompost, non-edible oil, no, and chemical fertilizer, no, nothing. No organic fertilizer also. So we have totally stopped, you can see, eliminated root causes of the global warming and climate change. And the residues of the crop are burned in chemical farming.
Gee.
In Punjab, two crore metric ton of the parali is burned.
Gee.
And in Haryana, 1.5 crore metric ton parali is burned. And the huge
the pollution, smoke. Right, the air pollution, absolutely.
Air pollution. And these are greenhouse gases. In Subhash Palekar natural farming, we are not burning any biomass, any residues of crop. We are utilizing entire residues as a mulching on the surface of the soil. So that humus is created by decomposition of this straw mulching.
Gee.
With the association of the Jivamutam, Ghanajivamutam as the best culture of the microorganism. And
gee,
humus is the fertility and productivity of the soil. Humus is the liveliness of the soil. So we are creating humus, not necessary at all to burn the biomass. And in entire world, the residues of the crops are burned. They are pushing, they are giving the support to the global warming, climate change, and they are creating so many problems.
Gee.
Subhash Palekar natural farming is the best solution to solve global warming and climate change.
Sir, I have to ask you, I know you mentioned chemical fertilizer and additives. What about pesticides? How do pesticides factor into the theory?
Madam, one truth would be accepted by entire world. Medicine is not a remedy to cure any disease. Medicine is not a remedy to cure any disease, to activate our innate immunity, given by the God at the birth time. That is the real remedy. We are creating resistance power in the plant body.
Gee.
So they are not facing any insect and disease problem. And that humus is the responsible factor which creates the resistance power in the plant body.
Gee.
So in Subhash Palekar natural farming, no manure, no fertilizer, no insecticide, no fungicide, no herbicide, nothing. Not necessary at all. Unnecessary we are utilizing.
So it's once again, to reiterate, it's a proactive approach to the health of the crop instead of a reactive approach, that it's a weaker crop, therefore you need to reactively give it pesticides to protect it. If agar aap shuru hi ek stronger, more resistant crop ke saath karenge, to aapko usko pesticides dene ki zarurat hi nahi padegi.
And second matter, that is most important.
Gee.
Which food we are eating? It is a poisonous food. All the residues of chemical fertilizer, insecticides, fungicides, and herbicides are coming in our body cell
Gee.
As a toxic garbage. When we eat chemically grown food, In organically grown food also, we are consuming maximum poisonous heavy metals, just like cadmium, arsenic, mercury, lead. These are the heavy poisonous heavy metals.
Yeah.
That means when we eat organically or chemically grown food, we are consuming maximum residues of the poison in the body, and this poison destroys our immunity. And we face corona, cancer, diabetes, heart attack. Basically, if you want to fight with the corona, cancer, diabetes, heart attack, only solution, poison-free food, nutritious and medicinal food, which can be given only by Subhash Palekar natural farming. Chemical farming, no, you can't get the poison-free food, and organic also, you can't get poison.
I mean, it's you're right. It's like a vicious cycle ban jata hai. Pehle aapki crop hi agar usme pesticides hain, wohi pesticides jo crop ko bhi weak kar rahi hain, wohi aapke shareer mein aapke mein 10 problems create karti hain, aapko bhi weak karti hain, fir aapko dawaiyan leni padti hain, and it just never ends, right? But agar aap source se hi usko problem ko tackle karo, wo kabhi problem banti hi nahi hai. Dr. Palekar, I want to ask you, of course, this theory, what is the next step, right? But unfortunately, ek aur yahan pe ek choti si break ke liye hame rukna pad raha hai. Dr. Palekar, please don't go anywhere. Viewers, tusi bhi sanle sath jude raho. Milde hain break to us par. Bari fair hazir hain, tusi vekh rahe ho program aaj da mudda gal ho rahi hai. Poison free food, natural farming, which is different from chemical farming, different from organic farming. And shayad eh jo ek model present kita ja raha hai, eh vak vak duniya di problems da hal ho sakda hai, na ke sirf agriculture model da, but ek individual di health da, environment nu laake eh solution offer kar sakda hai. Is vishay te sade naal discuss karan layi sade naal jude han Dr. Subhash Palekar ji from Maharashtra. Dr. Palekar, we welcome you back to the program once more. Dr. Palekar, you have been working on these theories for decades. Millions of people have been implementing these theories with success. Aapne ek presentation Subhash Palekar natural farming theory ko leke Prime Minister Modi ko bhi di thi. Tell us about that.
Basically, the Niti Aayog, it is a planning commission of India, basically. They have searched out, because in 2013 election, Modi ji has given the assurance to the Indian people that if he will be elected, he will give the double income. Then Niti Aayog searched out which technology will give the double income. They have searched out chemical farmer, and they found that chemical farming is totally useless to give the double income. They have searched out organic farming, and they came in the conclusion that organic farming is totally useless to give the double income. They have searched out all other technologies in Gwalior Kushi also. They found that all technologies are totally useless, not giving the double income, but they are reducing the income, and they are creating so many problems. But when they have studied our models, Subhash Palekar natural farming model in India, and they surprise that it is the best technology which can give the all solution, and not only double income, more time income. And then they call me, vice chairman of Niti Aayog called me, planning commission, they said, sir, we would like to organize one workshop with you, please come on. I have given the date. In Delhi there was a big meeting, and all agricultural scientists and decision makers were present full day. And at last they satisfied. Then the government of India declared Subhash Palekar natural farming as a policy in the parliament budget session. Finance minister has announced that Indian government will promote only Subhash Palekar natural farming. That means it is a change in the policy. But I think that it is not correct that Indian government will accept only my technology, and they will not, they will ban another technology. It is not possible, because any change cannot be done immediately. We want to wait some time. But I think that government of India, specifically Narendra Modi, Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliant India, that is the slogan of Narendra Modi. And I think that it is the best decision has been taken by the Honorable Narendra Modi. And by means of the mass movement, we are supporting that decision because we also, everybody want Atmanirbhar, self-reliant India.
Mm-hmm.
And your Sikh community, Sikh brothers are spread out throughout the world, in Canada, Australia, America, California, in entire world. And they are basically hard worker. They love about agriculture. They will do agriculture and they will in the industry. So I will give my message to Sikh brothers in Australia, Canada, America, and all over the world. If you are the farmer, please don't use chemical farming. Don't use organic farming. Very hazardous, problem creator technology. Now it is very essential to stop the global warming, climate change, and only solution is Subhash Palyan Natural Farming. Please start Subhash Palyan Natural Farming. If they will come to power to me, I will give my free service to the entire Sikh community in the entire world.
Ji, Dr. Palekar, you know, government aside, because government moves at a different pace than science, right? You're a scientist. What timeline does the science dictate? Agar hum India ki hi baat kare, India mein nationwide, kya timeline hai ki is theory ko practice mein badla jaye? And what do you think is standing in the way? Is it just the big corporates, obviously? Or is it something else, maybe lack of understanding? Aapke khayal mein, nationwide is theory ko apnane ke liye, kya archane aapko rok rahi hain?
Nay, what I have suggested to government of India, or any government, state government also, you don't stop chemical farming, don't stop organic farming. Let it continue. But you select two farmers from each village for Subhash Palyan Natural Farming as a model. And when the model will be established, automatically entire farmers will follow this technology. Not necessary to give the government support. So specifically, they have to choose only two farmers from each village. They will listen to my workshop and they will start Subhash Palyan Natural Farming and they will establish a very beautiful model, and then automatically all the people of that village will take the initiation to start this technology. And it is very easy because we do not have any single rupee. I am not taking single rupee as the honorarium. I am giving my free services. And even not any input, no chemical fertilizer, no insect, no fungicide, nothing. Even local seed is giving more production in Subhash Palyan Natural Farming than hybrid seed and genetically modified seed. That means farmers will not purchase the seed also, will not purchase manual fertilizer also, nothing. And water requirement is only 10% in Subhash Palyan Natural Farming.
Wow.
We are utilizing maximum water from the atmosphere,
Gee.
Minimum water from the soil.
Gee.
90% water saving, 90% electricity saving. So I think that I have given the solid solution to solve the all problems, not only related to agriculture, social, socio-economical and health problem also. It is the duty of the consumers in the entire world. What they have to eat, they have to choose. Either poisonous or poison free.
Dr. Palekar, I'm so glad you mentioned this. जो आपका ये मॉडल है कि आप हर एक विलेज से शुरू करिए, दो फार्मर्स को मॉडल के तौर पे स्टार्ट करिए. You know, to get into the logistics of this, right? अगर दो फार्मर्स को एक विलेज में चुन लिया, उनको इस मॉडल पे स्टार्ट करने के लिए कोई सब्सिडी, कोई गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से उनको सहूलत की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी? What do they actually need to get started?
I am totally against subsidy. Subsidy is a subsidy. Farmers are not satisfied by a subsidy. Subsidy creates exploitation and corruption, you know. In Subhash Palyan Natural Farming, if you have only one local cow, only one local cow, Boss Indicus, you can cultivate 30 acres of land.
Wow.
You want only one cow, 30 acres, yes. And everybody is having one local cow.
Gee.
That means we do not want cow, we do not want seed, because we will supply the local seed to the farmers. And no manure, no fertilizer, cost of production zero.
Wow.
If cost of production zero, no subsidy, no loan. Loan waiver is given by the government. It is not possible to give every year. We want totally loan liberation. sustainable loan liberation. We do not want loan war. And number two, the cost of production of 1 kg wheat in Punjab in chemical farming, 40 rupees per kg. Government of India is giving 20 rupees. That means Punjabi farmers are lost in 20 rupees. But in Subhash Palekar natural farming, our farmers are selling 50 rupees per kg. Cost of production is zero.
Ji.
And we are getting 50 rupees. More than how many times? 5 times more income. That means if we want to solve this problem in Punjab, Haryana, where there is a problem, only solution Subhash Palekar Nursing, I think that. Because we are selling straight to consumer. We are awarded a mediator. We are awarded a mediator. So I will give the message that everybody wants to survive. Nobody wants to die with the cancer, diabetes, heart attack, and corona. And they know poison-free food is the best solution. And we have given the poison-free food.
Absolutely.
We are fighting with corona, cancer, diabetes, heart attack with full concentration.
Absolutely. Dr. Palekar, I think, you know, in a nutshell, if I had to sum up this theory, it really is, you know, if you go to the source of the problem, you never have to worry about finding a cure for the disease, because the disease never has a chance to exist. Dr. Palekar, you know, I thank you for your time today. Bahut informative ye discussion rahi. I'm sure hamare viewers ko ek naya perspective mila hai. Aapki is theory ke baare mein thodi si jankari sunke. We'd love to have you back on the show, sir. Thank you so much for your time. Yahan pe hum is sama zyada ijazat nahi deta. Have a good rest of your day, sir. And thank you once again for sharing this information with us. Sat Sri Akal, namaskar.
Namaskar, sir.
Ji. And my viewers, nu janne ne sirf ehi kehna chahndi ha. Is program nu laake, of course, there's a lot of questions. Khas karke agar tusi kis na kise had tak kisani de naal jude hoye ho, paave ho professionally ya dilon ya family todi piche ya kise vi had tak tusi paave abroad rende hoye vi in masliyan di qadar karde ho. You care about what you eat, what you put in your body. You know, khas karke in Western countries like America, Canada, UK, Europe de vich bahut qadar kiti jandi hai is cheez di ki organic honi chahidi hai, todi sabziyan kitho aa rahi hai, ki processed food de vich ingredients hai giyan tusi apne bachyan nu khwa rahe ho, ode naal ki tuhanu health de side effects, in sari cheezan nu laake बहुत कंसर्न्स अज दी डेट दे विच उठाए जा रहे हैं. सो की ए एक सोल्यूशन ऑफर कर सकता है? इंडिया दे विच ए मॉडल शुरू किया गया डॉक्टर सुभाष पालेकर नैचुरल फार्मिंग थियरी दे नाल दे नाल इस नू अपनाया जा रहा है. मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल इन इंडिया आर यूजिंग इट. सो किन्ना पोटेंशियल इस थियरी दा हैगा दुनिया भर इफेक्टिव होने का एंड टू सॉल्व सम ऑफ द लार्जर प्रॉब्लम्स फेसिंग अस, नॉट जस्ट इंडिविजुअल हेल्थ, नॉट जस्ट एग्रीकल्चर फूड रिसोर्सेज, बट द एनवायरमेंट इज well. So inside chizan di ajj thodi ji apan gal kiti in kise vi topics te agar tusi sade layi koi questions, comments, concerns rakhna chahnde ho zarur sanu likho info@justbroadcasting.com, ashmita@justbroadcasting.com. agar tusi Dr. Subhash Palekar layi koi question rakhna chahnde ho tusi sanu likh sakde ho. Hun sanu deo ijazat. Sat Sri Akal.